Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and we're going to talk a little bit more about Class 3 clear aligner cases. I'm going to specifically talk about Invisalign and Clear Correct, but you could pretty much extrapolate this into any aligner system that's out there. So if you've done Class 3 cases, first of all, you want to make sure you're working with an aligner system that has all the functionality that you need for a Class 3 case. So you have all different types of treatment modalities that you can use to get an ideal outcome. Next thing that you need to do is take a cephalometric x-ray and make sure you're getting cephalometric numbers. You need to find out a lot of different things from the ceph that's going to help you build it into your plan. You can't just bake it into your ClinCheck or your ClearPilot setup and expect the technicians to know what to do. There's more than one way to fix a Class 3, but there's a lot of different variables and you need to find the right way. And the right way might not be the way the patient's interested in. So before you even accept the case, before you even take a cent down on the down payment, you wanna make sure that you work up the treatment plan to ideal and the patient is okay with the experience, how they're gonna fix the Class 3. What is a Class 3? Well, Class 3 is when either the lower jaw is bigger than the upper jaw or the upper jaw is smaller than the lower jaw, assuming the patient is Class 3 skeletal, or it could be a combination of both. That's why you need to get the cephalometric numbers, because that is standard of care, because you need to have the diagnosis. You need to specifically say what the Class 3 is due to. Class 3 is due to mandibular prognathism, or Class 3 is due to maxillary deficiency. You need to have this on your treatment plan. This is standard of care. You also could have a Class 3 situation that's maybe just dental in nature. Maybe you take the cephalometric x-rays and you get cephalometric numbers and they're all within normal limits. And it turns out it's just the teeth kind of shifted. Maybe they lost a few baby teeth early and things kind of shifted. Those are a lot easier to fix. So that's why you need to know. Also, things I'm going to look at on a Class 3 case is I'm going to look at the inclination of the incisors relative to the denture bases, the inclination of the upper incisors relative to the maxilla, the inclination of the lower incisors relative to the mandible, as well as the inclination of the incisors relative to the cranial base, so that I know what the options are, because not all options are ideal depending on what you see in a cephalometric x-ray. What are our different options for Class 3? Assuming the patient is not growing, of course, if the patient is growing, the right thing to do is to fix it. You know, if they have a deficient maxilla, you use a face mask or one of these appliances to grow the maxilla after you do expansion. This is standard. You don't just, you know, flare the upper incisors to try to jump it. It's not the right thing to do. That's below standard of care. So let's say we have an adult, they're done growing, and we need to figure out what the right way to fix the Class 3 is. Well, like I said, you're going to go ahead and get that cephalometric x-ray. You're going to do the diagnosis first. You're going to find out which jaw is the one that's causing the issue, or is it just teeth? And then once you do that, the next thing I'm going to do is two other things I'm going to look at. I'm going to look at the inclination, and there's numbers for this. And if you want to go through our cephalometric playlist, there's a lot of content I have on this. If you ever need help one-on-one with a case, that's something we do as well at Straight Smile Solutions. If you want to learn it more academically, I can send you to people that can help you with that. So we're going to look at the inclination of the upper incisor. This is a crazy, crazy flared upper incisor. If you got numbers on this, and I think I actually may have numbers on a case like this in my cephalometric playlist, so you can look through it. This is borderline unstable, okay? If you took a CBCT, you'd probably see there's very little bone in front of it. It is not possible stable or even healthy or even long-term successful to flare this anymore. So you can't fix the Class 3 by tipping this forward. That's out. If anything, we need to upright this and make the Class 3 worse to put it in a more stable situation. The perpetrator here is going to be the lower. We need to fix it through the lower. Now, the lower incisors are also flared, but not at a point of danger. The reason I can say this is because I've seen thousands and thousands of cephs with their numbers. So now my eyeball is very trained to know what's right and what's not, okay? So definitely for here, I would be okay with fixing the Class 3 with anything that retroclined these a little bit. That would definitely help, okay? Maybe I would consider a lower incisor extraction for a case like this. Obviously, I'd have to play with it and see exactly how big the discrepancy is. Or maybe I do some sequential distalization of the lower teeth, scooting, since there's no impacted wisdom teeth or erupted wisdom teeth, scooting them back a millimeter or two per quadrant. That would really, that would probably be the best option here. A case like this, some people might pull out, like I said, lower incisor, they might pull out lower bis. It really depends on how severe the class three is. But if the class three was pretty severe, like somewhere between a half step and a full step, then I might consider a lower bi extraction because these teeth are proclined. If these teeth were retroclined, then I definitely would not do that. So many things you have to, you know, keep in mind. IPR helps for extremely, extremely minor class three. I mean, I'm talking like anterior contacts, not in crossbite. That is the only way you could use IPR. Lower incisor exo, that gives you 5.5 millimeters to 6 millimeters. It's a little bit more than you get with IPR. Again, same situation. It would have to be very, very, very minor. Premolar extraction would be for more severe. If both denture bases were flared and it was class one or maybe a millimeter class three, then I might consider taking out lower fours, which is first premolars, and upper fives, which is second premolars. But I would only do that if the patient wasn't growing and if the patient had crowding. So many things to keep in mind, lots of different options for class three. Elastics are also an option. I didn't list that here, but I have it in the picture. But again, this would have to be a crazy, crazy mild class three in order to get something with elastics. All elastics do is cant the denture bases, and it's not always super stable. You're not gonna get that much of a change. In order to even get that, you're gonna have to wear them 23/7 for many, many, many months. And it's very rare that you get that kind of compliance if you ever had to wear elastics like that. Just for a minor change, it's probably a lot easier just to throw some IPR in and be done. I rarely, if ever, add elastics to aligner treatment plans. If you've worked with me, I've just found out it's like so different than braces, you just don't need it. I see a lot of you are going nuts with the elastics, and I think it's hilarious. It actually causes, in my opinion, again, this is my clinical opinion, way more problems than it's worth, and patients hate it, so why not get rid of them? If it was like a severe class three, full step, lower premolar case, maybe I would add them. That would be like the one situation where I might add them. But that's just my personal experience. Other people might tell you something different. But I mean, I can tell you, I've seen tons of class three cases get fixed without elastics. I've seen tons of class two cases get fixed without elastics because I'm using sequential distalization. Why use elastics when you don't have to? So anyways, all right, hope that helps. Thanks.